Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, I'm Mia Tiffany, and today we are going to be watching a film that some moviegoers called anti-American propaganda. Are y'all ready for this? Okay, so the movie that we're going to be watching today was released in 1939, and it was directed by Frank Capra. Yes, everyone, I'm talking about Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. I'm so excited to watch this film with all of you, honestly, because I just needed an excuse to see another Jimmy Stewart film. So as I said, it was directed by Frank Capra, starring our man Jimmy Stewart, with other notable performances by Gene Arthur, Claude Rains, and so many more. According to IMDb, it says a naive man is appointed to fill a vacancy in the United States Senate. His plans promptly collide with political corruption, but he doesn't back down. So let me address the statement I said earlier in this video and give you some context. So this film came out a little over a month after the start of World War II. So when some government officials went to go see this film, and seeing all of the political corruption that was depicted in this film, they called it anti-American propaganda, basically used to aid the Axis powers during the beginning of the war. However, a lot of critics and audiences really took well to the film. In fact, they thought it was heartwarming and inspiring and a really wonderful story. And it also actually went on to be nominated for 11 Academy Awards at the Oscars of that year. So that's pretty cool. I am really excited to watch this with all of you. But before we do, y'all already know the deal. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification to stay in the loop. All right, everyone, it is time to get your snacks, get your drinks, and let us get in to Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. We are starting. I don't know if I said this, but my snack today is fruit snacks and a Nutri-Grain bar because I'm trying to be healthier and quieter.
Senator Joseph Payne. Yeah.
Hello. Not even 2 minutes in the movie and someone is already dead.
The governor's residence in Jackson City.
I suppose he'd drop dead if you ever said no to him.
Oh, no, my dear, this is no time for jokes. I've got to appoint a new senator.
The investigation will show that we're going to sell it to the state under phony names.
Dang, they're into some shady stuff.
That's my judgment.
Okay, so what I'm getting from this is these men of power are doing some shady dealings for this damn land. This damn land. And a senator had just passed away. And so the new senator appointee, they want him to be pretty much like a puppet or like someone that they can kind of just control. Okay, that makes sense. I just wanted to reiterate that so that I understood.
Taylor, no Taylor.
Taylor,
also, these kids really know
this?
Their politics.
Well, still running the show, any pop?
Gosh, Dad, hit of the boy Rangers.
Oh, a boy.
No, Dad. Just
I wonder why
just
Capra has the two boys at the closest to their father out of focus, and then the last three children who aren't speaking in focus. I noticed that. It's very interesting. And it's on both sides, too. I wonder why he decided to do it that way. Oh, and Jeff Smith. So, I mean, if that's not a sign, I don't know what is.
That's good enough for me. And there he found...
There he is.
A nugget.
He knew my father very well. Clayton Smith. Joe Payne was the finest man he ever knew.
Too bad he's a shifty senator.
I'll do nothing to disgrace the office of the United States Senator.
Ooh, they chose the right one, let me tell you.
Aw, heck, it's a briefcase, Jeff. Not a good big thing, Jeff.
Yes, but it carries a lot when you get to Washington.
Jimmy's character is always getting some sort of, like, bag. Because in It's a Wonderful Life, he got, like, that chest with his name encrusted on it, George. And now he's getting a briefcase. That's funny. I wonder if that's, like, something maybe that it was done intentionally. I don't know. He's crying. That kid is crying.
Well, it isn't much, but if you insist, there's this week's.
Boy stuff. Why, printer's ink runs in your veins, Jeff.
Whoa.
Jeff, you're just like your father.
Did you guys see that? Wait. I swear there was a man there just then. Well, look, there's a man sitting there. And then he's gone. What?
Jeff, you're just like your father.
I'm noticing now that there are some continuity issues in this film. But again, it's 1939. I'm not judging. Might not have been a thing. It's just I'm noticing it a lot. Oh my gosh, there's the White House. I've never been to Washington, D.C. I would love to go someday. There's so much history. I feel like when you're there, you're just surrounded by American history.
There was a bus outside, and I just naturally got aboard.
I mean, how can you not get on a sightseer bus in Washington, D.C.? I totally would do that.
I've been so thrilled in my whole...
Nice job you and the ambulance chasers did in the papers this morning.
Oh, did you like it?
Great.
I feel bad because I feel like they're all laughing at
him. Here you are, Senator. Not a bad desk either. Right over there, Senator Agnew.
Oh, that's the guy from... That's another actor from Where's the Wonderful Life.
Right over there, above the Vice President's chair.
Yeah, I wouldn't even know how to act. Like, for me, like, being on set for the first time, I'd be like, I don't know where to be. Like, I'd feel so foreign, you know? I feel like I can understand where he's coming from.
Now, our beloved country labors with such grave and disturbing problems. Look upon us, we beseech thee, and give us the light and the strength to be just and merciful.
Okay, so I read that this is not actually the Senate floor. This is a replica that they built in the studio. That is impressive. Wow. It is very realistic.
The gentleman about to be sworn in.
Oh my God, that's
aware
of the Sawyer
responsibilities of his high
from Miracle on 34th Street.
I refer to his astounding and shameless performance for the newspapers. A versatile performance,
and he's acting exactly like Sawyer would act in this situation. Oh my God. Oh my God. Gee whiz. I don't think you can go around hitting people. But I get it.
That guy Smith's punching everybody he meets. Just get away from him. Oh, Tarzan!
Punching everyone he meets. That's funny.
Yes, sir, like a Christmas tiger. He'll nod his head and vote. Yeah.
I do not like the way that they are treating him.
Yes, sir, we're going right ahead with it.
Going right ahead with what?
The bill, my bill for a national boys camp. Where's my briefcase? Oh,
There's just so much passion inside of him. And Jimmy does a really, really beautiful job of conveying this childlike interest. So I commend him for that. That is why we love Jimmy Stewart.
Yes, sir. The big day finally arrives and Congress adjourns. Catching on, Senator?
Jean Arthur, I really love her as an actress. Like there's something about her that just exudes this strong energy that I love. Like, you can tell she's a woman who has come to a workplace full of men, but she's been able to hold her own. They're just really doing a good job of portraying their characters and also letting themselves kind of come out. And as an audience member, I definitely feel that.
I know Senator Payne will do all he can to help me because he's a wonderful man, isn't he, Mr. Saunders?
If only he
knew my
father very well. What was really going on.
Yeah, what's your first name?
Why?
Of course, I know what it is. Violet.
Oh my God, we're playing the name game now.
Abigail.
No.
Letitia?
Letitia.
Lena?
No, now stop it.
You might as well tell me. I got a lot more of you.
Oh, he's so cute.
It's Clarissa.
Clarissa. Running about a quarter of a mile on either side of Willard Creek.
That's where the dam is, isn't it?
Willett Creek, Willett, W-I-L-L-E-T.
It's where the shady land dealings are happening.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. What does that mean?
Mr. President!
Wow. Okay, we're starting. Okay. Stop laughing at him!
You may proceed, Senator.
This camp to be situated on the land at and adjacent to the headwaters of a stream known as Willett Creek in Terry Canyon.
Yep. Oh my God. No, you're falling for the wrong woman.
Yes.
So you want to be a senator, huh? You're going to build a camp on Willett Creek, a dam going up where you think your camp's going to be. That's why that ritzy dame took you in tow.
Oh
my
God.
That's why they sent you here in the first place, because you don't know a dam from a bathtub.
Boy's different.
He's honest.
Oh, now he has a change of heart.
Besides, he thinks the world of me. We can't do this to him.
Since I picked you out of a fly-specked hole in the wall and blew you up to look like a senator...
You can't owe this man anything.
Well, maybe you don't.
Oh, my goodness.
Create and erect public improvements on rivers, harbors, and roadways.
I can see something building inside of him.
Section 40.
This section of the bill, this dam on Willard Creek, is nothing but...
President.
Does Senator Smith wish to yield to his colleague, Senator Payne?
No.
Why, yes, sir.
Yes,
proceed,
sir.
Senator.
I'd say no.
President, I consider Senator Smith unworthy to address this body.
He's... What?
Boys, go out and get the senators.
Yes, sir.
Oh, my God. So he... Did he... He just, like, stabbed Smith in the back. Oh, everyone's coming back for this one. Oh, my goodness. Did he do it to protect him?
May I proceed, Senator?
I have conclusive evidence to prove that my colleague owns the very land described in his bill.
What? So they... Okay, hold the phone. Wait a second. So are you telling me that these men, these elitist... men, like, they did this scheme to make Smith... I don't even know. What? Oh my God, they have receipts.
It is my professional opinion that it is definitely in Jefferson Smith's own handwriting.
That is not true. It cannot be true. So they basically, like, forged papers saying that he owns the land that he's trying to build the boys' camp on. But that's totally not true. Oh my gosh. What in the world? This isn't... I didn't know that this was going to go this way. What? All because he wanted to do good for the boys in his Boy Rangers program. You know what? This reminds me of Legally Blonde. Oh yeah, he's here. Oh yeah. He came to play, baby. He came to play.
Mr. President, I trust the chairperson.
I have the floor. The senator can have nothing
Shut
to say
up,
to this.
Shut up, Mr. Sawyer.
I'm not going to be either in bad grace.
The chair recognizes Senator Smith.
Yes.
Can the senator yield?
No, sir, I will not yield.
Woo! I'm sorry, I love
this.
And
the same man, Mr. James.
this got so, so good.
And the wild horses aren't going to drag me off this floor until those people have heard everything I've got to say, even if it takes all winter.
So he is about to hold this Senate floor like there's no tomorrow. Oh my goodness.
What do you got, Dick?
Miss Saunders.
Oh, he still believes in him. I love it. This says I'm in love with you. He's right. Oh my God, why is this so beautiful?
Yield. Oh no.
Oh no, don't yield that floor, baby.
Hey, I feel fine.
This is eerie. I'm just gonna say it. This is eerie. What do you get? You're gonna run children off the road? Are they serious? I don't know. I feel like this is, like, really eerie. They're running children off the street, silencing them, slapping them in the face, taking their papers. For what? Power?
Just get up off the ground. That's all I ask.
Oh my God, his voice.
Get up there with that lady.
While I was researching this film, I read that they gave him some sort of concoction, or like, it was like a lethal concoction because there was like mercury in it. And I don't think people knew the side effects of mercury. It weakened his vocal cords so that he could sound authentic. And I'm thinking to myself,
that doesn't sound like a good idea.
Or compromise with human liberties.
Oh my God, his breathing is labored.
And if that's what the grown-ups have done with this world that was given to them, then we better get those boys' camps started fast and see what the kids can do.
Y'all, I gotta drink some water after that.
The people's answer to Mr. Jefferson Smith.
It's because they're being fed lies. They are being fed lies. No. And he falls.
No!
Oh my God. Was he trying to kill himself?
What's the matter?
I'm not fit to be a senator. I am not fit to live. Every word about Taylor and me and Graft and the rotten political corruption in my state.
Wow, so he gave himself away.
Order, gentlemen, please.
Just to hell with it, dude. my goodness. That's it? That's the end. Oh, wow. Okay. Wow. Well, what a way to end a movie. I kind of wish there was more, but I guess it was pretty much wrapped up. Wow. That movie was really, really good. I have to say, I'm going to go ahead and give that one 9.5 of 10. I really enjoyed it. I think it was really well done. The only thing that I found to be a little bit irksome is the cuts were very obvious. Again, this was 1939. And also there were a bit of continuity issues within the film. And then there's like the little romantic part of me that kind of wanted Saunders and Smith to share like a little kiss at the end. But of course, whatever. You can't get everything, right? But overall, I think it was a really great movie. All right, everyone, that does it for this video. If you liked it as much as I did, please give it a thumbs up. Also, please subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification to stay in the loop. If you have any suggestions or any comments or anything you want to let me know, please let me know in the comment box below. Thank you to all of you who have been recommending and suggesting. I have been listening and I have been putting all of your recommendations into my master movie list. Thank you to all of you again. Please stay safe and healthy out there, and I'll see all of you in the next video. Bye, everybody.